What is going on, guys? Today is Saturday. I don't remember the date, so I'm not even gonna say it. I promised you guys that I would walk you all through what I'm doing to make weight for this meet and how this is going and track that process. So that is what I'm gonna do for you guys today. I'm about 3/4 of the way through with this gallon of water right here. And we are on day one of the water load. When I talk about water load, and what I mean by that is we try to increase our water intake along with the sodium intake to essentially activate these enzymes that are responsible for getting water out of the body in simplest terms. And then later on, we start to taper down water, taper down sodium, and our body kind of expels more water than it originally had to put us in this temporary state of dehydration in order to make weight. And that's kind of what we do. But last night I used this secret key. I'm doing this back step, acting like I know where it is, but actually I have no clue where I put it. I think it might be in this cabinet right here. And here we go. Ultra Olympiador, super sketchy colon cleanser. It's actually, there's no weird shit in it. It's all like roots and grass and fucking weird shit. But it works amazingly. I got it off of Amazon a couple years ago as per recommendation of Tina Tornado. Some of you guys may know her, some of you don't. I use it in a slightly different way than other people would. Some people would use it as kind of like this last minute laxative to kind of clear you out before meet day, but I think that that's really taxing and I would prefer to use less stressful forms of intervention later on in the game when you're already kind of dehydrated. I use it at the beginning of the week to clear out all of this gut mass before switching over to a really low fiber and low residue diet. If you want to hear me talk more specifics about exactly what foods I use and what foods I buy at the grocery store, watch my Water Cut Keys video. But I use it at the beginning of the week to empty myself out, clear out all that gut mass, switch to a really low fiber, low residue diet, which doesn't cause a lot of bulk in the intestines. And you can lose, studies show, about 1.5% of total body weight just from switching the foods over, even if you equate calories. Now that's pretty amazing because essentially you're getting rid of all of this non-functional gunk and shit, literally, in your stomach in order to make weight. And that food serves you no purpose when it's sitting in there just taking time passing through your digestive tract. Now, if you have the option between losing that weight and losing water, especially dipping into that 4% or more of total body weight loss where losing water starts to affect your muscle physiology and performance, it seems like a no-brainer to me. So, I woke up this morning at about 85 kilos, which is the lightest I've been in a long time, just from using that. And here's an example of one of the foods that I talk about in my Water Cut Keys video. And I don't think I really have to load water that aggressively this time around, which is amazing. And I have a PM weigh-in. So I'm just gonna wake up heavy on meat day. Realistically, if I stayed 85 right now and just maintained that the whole week, I would cut 1 kilo, just 1 kilo. And then I would spit the morning of with these guys right here, Jolly Ranchers. Talked about them in my last video. I was able to lose almost 3 pounds from spitting with these for a couple hours. Granted, it did blow up my mouth. Like I was just like, my whole mouth was just torn up and raw. Didn't feel that good. but we do what we can, right? We do what we must. We do everything for the performance. Would you die on the platform? Would you be willing to die on the platform?
Some of you may die, but it's a sacrifice I am willing to make.
If I have the option between something that's not really that taxing on the body that might suck a little bit, I would much rather do that than do something that would be more taxing on the body that just like makes me feel mentally more at peace. Because I know, I'm confident that these plans work. Also, for those of you guys who have water cut, you know why those are important. But anyway, we're gonna head to the gym now. Today is my last heavy bench day of the prep. Crazy, right? So my volume this week is actually not really any lower on bench. But today is my last heavy day, and then going into next week, I'll start to trickle things down. So I'm sure some of you are asking, like, Sean, like, what have you eaten so far today? Well, I drank a lot of juice because liquid calories, really, really efficient way to get in calories without really gaining much weight because you're just gonna pee it out. Eggs, full fat cheese, and like I had whole eggs, egg whites, and American cheese. delicious. American cheese, processed. I don't give a shit. Tastes amazing. Then I had some potato bread, and then now I'm about to have a protein shake in this beautiful Thanos-colored shaker bottle. I'm gonna head to the gym, like I told you guys, and let's see if I can squeeze out just a tiny bit more on bench this cycle. Just a tiny, tiny, tiny bit more. And then bench 10 kilos less on the platform because the ER rack does what it does. I'm not saying I'm gonna PR today for sure on bench, but I feel good, man! We're taking 190 next, baby. Let's go!
Asking me, I know they mad at me. Nah, hop in the coupe, then I slide like it's fast and I break out, put it on the triple fade. I'm not from Canada, but I see a lot of teams. Dismantle up, I know how to handle up. Light the candle up, make you put a banner up. Toss a 50 up, make them tie the club up. Take your bitch out the game, I had to sub up. No masterpiece. 10 bad bitches and they after me. One bad bitch look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dump like an athlete.
What do you fucking think about this?
What?
Come on, man.
So that, yeah, man, come in, join me. Let's talk. Yeah, so that, I'm gonna move this water out of the way before I talk. That attempt at 496 was brutal. You're fine. That attempt at 496 was absolutely brutal. 474 moved pretty well. And I was honestly, I just wanted to go for 496 today anyway. It was just gonna happen regardless. What do you want? You want peanut? You want regular? What do you want?
Can I have a Snickers, please?
You want a Snickers? Yeah, man, I got you. I'll give you both of those. Here you go.
Thank you.
Happy Halloween. 474 moved pretty well. 496 was kind of something I was gonna go for anyway. Today is the best I've ever felt on bench, and I know that I can get and replicate that same Saturday feeling on Thursday if I just pull back that volume Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of next week, because that's what really beats me up going into the Thursday session. Once I unracked it, it felt pretty good in my hands. It felt heavy, obviously, but it's just a weight I've never held before, and because of that, when I got to my chest, like, here's the thing about benching like a cheater, okay? When you bench like this, the margin for error becomes so, so, so small, okay? And when I got to my chest, I felt kind of like this weakness in my forearms, like the weight was just heavy enough that it caused pain in my forearms, and it just wouldn't let me push. Obviously the weight's too heavy, I couldn't hit it today, but because, you know, the way that it made itself too heavy was that it created this feeling of like, holy shit, like my hands can't squeeze. Like it was just more weight on my joints than I had, and it just felt very foreign. So 496 didn't move, my back downs moved really well. I hit a PR today on volume work, hit 419 for a 4x4, which is the most I've ever done for more than one set. I think 419 for five is the most I've ever done for one single set. So doing 419 for four sets of four is humongous for me. Sam just left me. Sam, come back! That's it for the day, honestly. I'm gonna show you guys now the clips from last Thursday's final SBD day. The best training day overall that I have had this entire prep, as expected. I told you. And once I start to pull back this volume, that top end strength is gonna resurface. And I'm so sore from that session because I hit weights at like speeds that I just haven't in so long. And I think it was just kind of a shock to my body and created some acute fatigue and soreness. But I'm very happy with Thursday's session, so I'm gonna show you guys that now. I already finished my first gallon of water and I have to go home and drink my second. So Thursday.
Come on. Go, Sean. Yep. Oh man, hanging out with my best friend today. Guys, today's Sunday. We are 4 days out from Raw Nationals. And I am at the beginning stages of loading up this water. Put some Trioral, which is a rehydration salt, because you don't want to have too much water without enough salt. And Gatorade in there. About to get on a client call real quick. Oh my god. I can't believe we're almost here. Anyway, I woke up this morning for you guys, just to let you know, I woke up at 86 kilos on the dot. Yesterday was 85, today was 86, most likely because of the increased water intake. Granted, normally, my weight usually starts to fall off immediately when I start loading water, but because of the colon cleanser that I used, I probably woke up a little bit excessively light yesterday. I wouldn't expect to be 85 just right off the bat like that. So that is likely a result of that. So we're 86 right now. And I use, guys, use your data because it's important. It gives you good benchmarks. I use past cuts and what I weigh every single morning, and I just compare it to the same corresponding day out. I'm doing the same thing now. I'm about 0.1 off from where I was for the meet that I did in April, where I woke up a kilo over. That's kind of what I want to do this time. Like I said, I'm not trying to wake up at weight the morning of, because I weigh in at 4 p.m. and I don't want to sit around all day and just sit at weight, because I'm not going to be able to eat or drink anything. So I might as well be more hydrated and then lose it as I get closer to weigh-ins. Because being dehydrated for a shorter period of time is always, always, always better. Trust me,
And don't panic about weight. Like, if you have everything you need, if you're prepared, you're gonna make weight. Okay, there's no reason you won't make weight. Unless, of course, your scale's off. So, for those of you water cutting, make sure that your scale is calibrated. And if it's not calibrated, make sure that you know how much it's off by. Either take a calibrated plate, put it on there, see how much it's off by. Or weigh yourself on your scale and then weigh yourself on someone else's scale that you know is calibrated and see what the difference is. Anyway, gonna get on a client call and I will see you guys right after it because I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna eat for breakfast. I'm gonna sit here and just drink this miserable gallon of water while I'm on the call. And then we're gonna go to the gym because we have the last squats and deadlifts of the prep. Yes, 4 days out, the last squats and deadlifts of the prep. It is such a relief. I'm gonna take my squat opener for a single, last warm up for a few singles after that, and then some super, super light deadlifts, literally like 70%, 75%, something like that. And that's it for you guys today. No bench, because there's no bench on Sundays. And then tomorrow, Tuesday, Wednesday, I'll have bench sessions. I'll take you guys through that, and that's pretty much it. I'm gonna be in Chicago Tuesday morning, so tomorrow's the last day you're gonna see me in this house. Until next week, of course, when Nationals is over. She broke my heart to the core, so what? I guess we all gotta grow up. I'm just an icon living. Start a record level, this bitch just did it. Boom. Interview, cover 5 minutes. Boom. We are too hot in the business. Boom. I'm going straight to the top of the code. We should just chill and maybe take it slow. When we get up there, we know where to go. And we can chill and just look at the view. Damn. Lord of Yellow Rock. Take you in back of the bills. Make you respect your rage. Take you across the tracks. Take you as a public face. The people gon' call it the truth. I ain't really trap on the credit. I just pay all of my bills. I just respected the game. Got my name all in the news. Trippin' on all of my moves. Call me on this, got a lot more to prove. Remember I came in this bitch. Fresh out the camp, nothing on you. So, today was a very uneventful one. Kind of expected it, to be honest, because Thursdays have been historically just the best all-around day. And today was better than most Sundays have been on squat, even though it wasn't as good as it was on Thursday. Even though we're pulling back volume, we expect the peak to happen on Thursdays. Like, when you pull back, the Thursday will get a little better each time, and now that we're getting ready for the meet, this Thursday should be the strongest I've ever been. I want to thank my man Xavier.
Hey, good night, brother. Wonderful night.
Good night, guys.
Good luck on Thursday, man.
Thank you, dude. I appreciate it. I want to thank my man Xavier and Nick, who is not here, but thank you to these two for letting me train at this amazing gym for this prep. It was a very grueling one, a very up and down sort of prep, but I felt very productive and ultimately very confident, and I could not do it without the support and like the care that these two guys have for their gym. Like, they both compete, they both lift every single day. They're both training for meets. Like, Nick is doing Nationals. Xavier, I think, is competing in December locally, but they are on the gym floor every day, willing to film, willing to spot, willing to load, do everything that they can to make sure that everyone's gym experience is the best that it could possibly be. And I think that's a huge contributing factor to everybody's progress and ultimately their enjoyment when they train here. So if you are in Long Island or even New York, come visit United Barbell. It's an amazing gym. I'm gonna go home, eat, drink. It's crazy how you can drink like over 2 gallons, but when you have enough salt, you're really fucking thirsty. I was just telling Xavier this, like I already finished my 2nd gallon and I'm still thinking about water. Whereas normally I don't even think I drink 1 gallon on most days. So it's really crazy how the body works. Everything is just about balancing concentrations. So I'm gonna go home and eat some really boring food. And yeah, that's the end of this prep. I just have a couple more really light bench sessions for you guys and making weight. That's all there is to it. Don't forget to like, don't forget to comment, don't forget to comment, don't forget to subscribe, do whatever you gotta do. Remember, no bad days. We are 4 days out. Weigh-ins at 4 p.m., 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 6 p.m., 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The flight starts, and we're ready to go.